Hello everyone, in this video we'll talk about operation modes of bioreactors. When it comes to bioprocessing and bioengineering, the reactors can operate in several ways and several processes can take place, such as batch processes, fed batch or continuous processes. In this video we'll get a quick overview, advantage and disadvantage of all of these processes. And then in subsequent videos, we would delve into the details. In earlier videos, we have talked about the upstream and downstream processes. So in case you have missed it, then quickly go to the video and revise your concepts. The link is given in the I button. So in this video, let's focus on the different type of processes that takes place in an industrial setting. So the first operation mode that we are going to talk about is a batch process. Then we're going to talk about fed batch and continuous processes. In batch process, all nutrients, media, cells are provided in the beginning, and at the end of the run, you collect the product. I mean in the crude form. And later on, the crude product is taken for downstream processing. So it's fairly simple. Give all the reagents necessary for the bioreaction, wait for the incubation time and obtain the crude product. This is known as batch process. Now there are several advantages and disadvantages of this process. First of all, it's fairly simple and the duration is short. And there is less chance of contamination because you are opening the reaction vessel only one time and in the beginning of the time. Okay, and lastly, separation of batch material for traceability is way more easier in this process, and overall it's easy to manage these kind of processes. But the problem is product is mixed with nutrients, reagents, cell debris and toxins, which might affect the yield. And in industrial settings, the yield is the biggest thing, right? Yield and the profit. Next, we are going to talk about the production time. So since after one run of the bioreactor, there would be some downtime, then the effective productive time is really low. So overall productivity of this process is not so high. A little bit modification in this batch process is known as fed batch process, where nutrients or substrates can be injected sequentially. So you begin with a partial concentration of nutrient or media, and eventually one can inject nutrients or media throughout this process. Now, this allows the harmful effect of high concentration of media at the beginning. Let's say the media might inhibit the growth kinetics of these cells. So, this particular process can overcome those kind of drawbacks. Next, we'll talk about the advantage and disadvantage of this process. Now, this actually extends the culture's productive duration. So, reactor downtime versus productive length is more in this case. It can be used to switch on genes and switch off genes in case of a specific type of bioprocess, let's say, which requires periodic switching on and switching off of a gene or a operon. So, in those cases, fed batch process is very good. Now it can be manipulated for maximum productivity using different feeding strategies. So you can modulate the feeding strategies to optimize this process. But the problem is, though it is better than a batch process, it still allows the buildup of inhibitory agents and toxins. Now, I mean, it may produce high cell density, which might cause a problem in downstream processing and other cases. So there are disadvantages to this process as well, but we should also focus on the added advantages. Next, we'll talk about the continuous process. The idea behind continuous process is to keep the culture conditions constant. By always adding fresh medium and harvesting the used medium. So here we would understand the process of steady state. So here you would have a media reservoir or substrate reservoir from where you can give sequential input over time, and you would have a sequential outlet. Like you can take out the products, which would have your cells and media. You can take it out in different point of time. So sequential input and sequential output is the key feature of continuous process. Moreover, in continuous process, the dilution rate of the media is exactly equal to the specific growth rate. And that tells us that cell density or the viable cell density remains constant throughout this process. And that's the biggest advantage of continuous process. In modern day industry, they are really adopting these continuous processes over fed batch or batch processes. The advantage we have already kind of discussed, that it allows maximum productivity because reaction downtime is low and you don't have to shut down the reactor after every run. So the time for cleaning, sterilization, all of these aspects which can delay the whole process or reduce the effective time is minimized using a continuous bioprocess. Lastly, it provides a steady state for metabolic studies. So if you're especially doing metabolic studies in industry or trying to make or purify some metabolites, this kind of processes would be very useful. Now, though theoretically it looks very advantageous, but the difficulty is to keep a constant population of viable cells, right? So this is practically difficult. Okay, the products of a continuous process cannot be neatly separated into batches. So traceability is difficult. Maybe one in batch process, maybe one batch was not good. You can discard that batch. But here, if the whole run is defective, you have to throw a hell lot of product at the end of the day. So traceability is a difficult factor. And there is increased risk of contamination because you are injecting media and taking out media and products in sequential fashion, right, over time. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of all of these three processes. Now let me summarize. In batch process, we saw that productivity is low because the downtime is really high, but it's easily manageable. That's the only advantage of a batch process. Now in fed batch process, both the downtime and productivity is kind of moderate, so it's like kind of like an intermediate stage. And the continuous process is now adopted in many industries, and the downtime is low, the productivity is high, and we know why. In the subsequent videos, we would delve into details of all of these processes and look at some mathematical equation which would help us to understand these processes. So stay tuned till the end. And if you want to support me, you can support me via Patreon. And if you're an Indian viewer, you can support my channel via this QR code. This is Vim UPI, so you can anytime pay me via this. And if you like this video, give it a quick thumbs up. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And you can use my code AP10 to get a 10% discount on my Unacademy courses. Thank you.